What is selling and what is the basic approach to sales? Selling is first and foremost a transaction between the seller and prospective buyer or buyers, that is the target market, where money or something else of monetary value is exchanged for goods and services. So the best way to define selling is to focus on the sales skills that are necessary to make the transaction happen. Defining selling as the art of closing the deal encapsulates selling's essence. However, that being said, there is a huge difference between a basic sales exchange such as buying petrol at a gas station for your car and buying the car. In the first instance, the exchange is built on a simple need. Your car's gas tank is empty, you need to fill it. There may not be and probably isn't even a salesperson involved. In the second, the exchange is built on manufactured need that is created through marketing. You think you need a car because you have been persuaded to believe that. Enter the salesperson to direct and meet your need. So sales is actually a spectrum, and most selling consists of performing the art of persuading the customer that buying the product or service will benefit him or her. Some people excel at directing and persuading. These are the super salespeople that truly are worth their weight in gold. How do you sell something? Whatever product or service you're selling, you need to focus your selling efforts on communicating the benefits of your product or service to the customer. The benefits may be tangible or intangible, but unless the individual consumer is convinced that he or she will personally experience the benefits, your product or service won't sell. Think about it. Why do women smear color on their eyelids? Did anyone in the world ever actually need a hula hoop? That's the art of selling. While we are looking at the basic approach to selling, there are many types of selling definitions. If you're interested in improving your sales skills, you'll find that there are supposedly many kinds of selling that you should use or avoid. Here are some of the common approaches. The first, aggressive selling, also known as high-pressure sales, where the bottom line in this type of selling is that if the prospect walks, the sale is lost. The style is hard driving. This is the salesperson who won't take no for an answer. The second is transactional selling. This approach focuses on making quick sales. There is no attempt to form a long-term relationship with the customer. While transactional selling tends to be looked down today, it does have its place. Looking at it from a customer's point of view, sometimes a simple transaction is all what the customer wants. The third is consultative selling, or also known as relationship selling. Consultative selling depends on developing long-term relationship with the customer. The salesperson is to get to know the customer's needs and wants so that he or she can do the best job in giving the customer what they want. We'll be talking about consultative selling in a separate video. The fourth is collaborative selling. Collaborative selling takes relationship selling one step further. This sales approach depends on partnership mentality between the buyer and seller. You will learn more about the difference between consultative and collaborative selling in a later video from us. So, the basic approach to sales begins with quickly position your company and set on the agenda. Stop talking, ask questions and listen to uncover needs. Share examples, that is similar solutions that match needs. Qualify along the way and finally get closure on the next steps. So let's look at each one of these five steps. First, quick positioning. Similar to an elevator pitch, give the client just enough information to give them context. We are an IT services firm that specializes in project governance and technical staffing. We do this by providing talented resources supported by best practices. Our customers like what we truly solve as their business needs. We are a printing firm that specializes in custom projects requiring quick turnaround times. Our digital processing provides top quality printing with reduced setup and production requirements. The second is uncover needs. More important to ask questions than to talk. Probe for pain points at all levels, working up and down levels. For example, resource pain, usually shortage of material or manpower resources. Project pains, usually a time overrun on a project. Financial pains, constraints in terms of budgetary controls. Marketing pains, fall in sales. Organizational pains could be in terms of the procedures and bureaucracy in the organization and the slowness in decision making. Current supplier pains, those that relate to problems that they're facing with current supplies. The third is to share examples. Present and work through some preliminary solutions using examples. For example, we can probably help you with either of those two projects. For example, we recently did a project for XYZ Corporation where I realize that your needs may be different, but that gives you an idea of our capabilities. Check for responsiveness. Rephrase what you hear the client saying. Work through alternatives best as you can. Demonstrate industry knowledge. The fourth is qualify and scope along the way. I'm sure we can help you. Does your company have the budget for this project? Who would make the final decision if you choose to work with us? Tell me about them, their roles, what are they struggling with, willingness to consider new partners, etc. Do any other vendors provide you with these services? How do you think we are different? How do we suggest that we move forward? And finally, get closure on the next steps. When do we meet again to discuss the matter further? Bring in other resources to help assess the requirements. Offer to start with a baby step. Just take a small piece of work to begin with. The art of selling, you know, what makes a successful salesperson? The ability to build long-term relationship one at a time. The ability to listen and stay in tune with the needs of the customer. Not promising what they can't deliver. Tenacity. A good salesperson knows that it may take several attempts to make a sale and never gives up on a potential customer. Self-motivation and positive attitude. Successful salespeople have a high level of initiative and don't need micromanagement. They constantly look for new opportunities and view setbacks as learning experiences. Constantly looking for ways to promote products and services by handing out business cards and other promotional material to get the word out. This includes use of emails, websites, updates, and social media postings so customers can be kept up to date with the latest product or service offering via Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and Pinterest, etc. Investing in his or her community. Investing where you live increases the likelihood that customers will return the favor when they have a need for your products or services. In truth, the type of selling approach you should use depends on your personality, your industry, and your customer. As a salesperson, you will be more comfortable with some styles of selling rather than others, and probably more successful with that type of sales as a result. And while there is a kernel of truth in the axiom that good salesperson can sell anything, particular approaches have become synonymous with particular industry. Used car salespeople, for example, are infamous for their aggressive selling techniques. The best-selling approach, though, is the one that results in a sale, which is why the best salespeople are able to successfully use different types of selling depending on who their customer is. This brings us to the end of this part where we discussed the basic approach to sales. In the next part, we will address what is the AIDA theory of selling. Thank you.